Everywhere, like, we're just like, we might as well, like,
that's a honeymoon phase,
you know what I'm saying, though? But then it's still on and popping.
That's good, good.
After
good for you.
I have a girlfriend by default right now. I'm glad she don't listen, but I've been with her for actually a year and a week, and I haven't asked her to be my girlfriend, and she became my girlfriend because she didn't leave me alone after that. Like, we hooked up the first night, bro, and she's never left me alone to this day. So she's my girlfriend by default.
Yeah,
like we don't have an anniversary. I haven't asked her to be my girlfriend. She's just been my girlfriend for the
hold on.
The first day we met, I guess.
Matt needs to take some notes.
She's your bottom, then.
She's my problem. Yeah,
no bottom. Oh.
No. I feel like I need to go.
What's her email? I'll send this to her.
Her email. It's BriannaReese123@gmail.com. Oh, oh,
he's giving it out.
Yeah, dude, send her an email. Send her a picture of me.
Have you guys ever gotten into a relationship by default?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Which one, John?
But I feel like for me, it was because, you know, I was a few months in, and it got to the point where it's like, well, what are we doing? You know, we've been seeing each other for, you know, X amount of months now. And it's like, I mean, I don't know. I thought we were just, you know, hanging out. Didn't work for me like it did for you. And
well, it hasn't worked out for me, bro, but don't let me go.
And then I got the card. It's like, yeah, no, these things happen naturally. And, you know, if you see each other for this long. And for me, it was like, I was cool with just what we were doing, you know?
Yeah.
I dropped this one girl off that I'd been seeing for a few months, and she wouldn't get out of my car. She was starting to cry and everything, like, about how she couldn't figure out what was going on.
I'm too prideful. I'm too prideful for that.
Here's this. I'm not sleeping with anybody else.
She just right now. To get out. Well,
I mean, you should. She's not your girlfriend, bro.
Right, exactly.
You do whatever you want.
You do whatever you want.
Mm-hmm.
I got some friends tonight if you want to go hang out.
Keeping it real.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't think there's a time limit, but
Ashley seems like she would be the girl that'll, like, cut your throat while you're sleeping if you
want to stay out. 100%. Yeah? 100%. Yeah.
Oh, man.
How do you think AJ stayed around?
Yeah, he's scared.
He's scared, exactly.
No, I mean, if, like, that's the thing, though. I'm not going to hold you for ransom. You know, like, if it's not, I'm not, like, I'm one of those people that's like, if you're going to strain, you're going to do something, you're doing me a favor. I'm going to do my thing, too. Like, I would slit your throat, though, if you cheated on me. But I'm not going to be like, you better be my boyfriend. Like if you don't want to be my boyfriend, you don't want to be my boyfriend. I don't care.
Can you cheat on him? Is it okay for you to, like, mess around?
No.
So there's no messing around.
This is legit. This is as legit as
well, yeah,
it gets.
You guys have been together for, what, six or 7 years?
Six.
Jeez. Yeah, that's pretty.
It's almost a domestic partnership. Like,
you could claim that. You get those tax benefits.
You know what I'm saying?
There's some countries, right, after you're with them for 3 years?
It's 10, I think, in the United States.
It's 3 years in Spain, I think.
What's it called? There's a name for that, right?
Civil union or something? Yeah, Bob Marley had six wives because of that.
Jeez.
Yeah. Civil union, that's what it's called.
Well, are you going to be the next Bob Marley?
You got the hair for it. You don't see the luscious dreads he's got
in
here.
Hey, you see how much romance in these dreads have got, bro? Oh, my gosh. If these dreads could talk, bro.
Oh, my God. I would love to hear them. That would be a podcast in its own.
They talk for years.
That would be the name of it, if these dreads could talk.
Yes, yes.
I like that.
Yes.
We should do a segment. I got stories.
Oh, I would love to hear it.
If these dreads could talk. Well, here, Beto, question. Should I be scared or proud? I knew a girl for...
Never be scared. Be proud.
Ooh.
I don't even know what you're going to tell me. Be proud.
Hung out with this girl 3 times. Third time, slept with her. She's like, wow, I've never waited this long before. I was like, oh, God.
Oh.
Wore condoms, but I'm like, oh, God.
I would triple them
scared
up.
Scared or proud?
Well, be proud that you got somewhere. don't be proud that you waited 3 days, bro.
Nah.
Don't.
No.
No, be... scared that she said that.
But is she bugging you to be her boyfriend?
Not boyfriend, but she is bugging me. She's and it's like, kind of bugging me.
Don't do it.
No, you should run for the hills for that one. Because that one's going to lock you down.
All right. I'll text her right now, you guys.
And if you did a good job, she told her friends all about it, bro. So make sure you look up her friends. Tell her hello.
That's actually good. That's good advice.
I've done
that before.
Hey,
what's her email? Let's send her an email.
Bootyho@
Jeez.
I guess the verdict is still out. We don't know.
You just can't define it. I think what we came down to, you know.
Well, it's like you said, you know, nowadays it's kind of you. It's so. What did you say? It's so common to be. Casual
Tinder.
About it.
Yeah,
there's less importance to have to define it, right?
Yeah, no, I agree 100%. So, All right. Well, hey, that concludes today's show. Thank you so much for Beto for dropping in.
Thanks,
Pete. Don't forget to wear a condom.
We appreciate the pearls of wisdom. It's nonstop. Again, we are Skull and Bones Radio. We'll check you guys out, or guys, check us out next week on iHeartRadio and on iTunes, skullandbonesradio.com.
Yep.
All right. Bye.
We are Skull and Bones Radio.